After big victories in Tuesday's elections, Republicans are taking aim at one of their first targets, health care.
People who supported us, political independence, want it repealed and replaced with something else.
We should try to repeal it.
We're going to do everything we can to try and repeal and replace this thing.
Signed into law this spring, health care is one of President Obama's defining accomplishments.
This was the right thing to do.
Polls show that Americans are split on the issue, and there is this reality. With Democrats controlling the Senate and the White House, a complete repeal of the new law is all but impossible.
You can't fully repeal and replace this law until you have a new president and a better Senate.
So Republicans are pursuing other strategies to battle the health care law, such as blocking funding for the new programs and fighting in the courts.
The people's voice is going to be heard. The Constitution is going to be heard and defended and protected.
21 states have sued the Obama administration over health care. They're arguing Congress has no power to force people to buy health insurance.
We believe that the mandate that people go out and get insurance or that they face penalties is patently illegal and unconstitutional. And we have chosen to take a stand.
Judges have refused to dismiss the Maine lawsuits in Virginia and Florida, keeping the legal battle over health care brewing as the political battle heats up.
If the federal government can order you and me and everybody else in this country not only to buy health insurance, but what health insurance to buy, then the power of the federal government has essentially been made unlimited.
A ruling in the Virginia case is expected by the end of the year, but regardless of what any of these lower courts decide, the fight over health care is probably headed here to the Supreme Court. Russ?
Jen Crawford at the Supreme Court. Thank you.